you have done incredibly well too. I think it's fair to say that.
Yeah, thanks, Seamus. Yeah. Look, they're only starting to count the votes now, but based on the tally figures, yes, it looks like Pope Matt and all
A very, very strong strategy.
Yes. Well, as I said from the start, Matt and I and the whole team behind us, we as director, we worked as a team. Our aim was to get two Sinn Féin seats. So we did not consider retaining the Queen's seat as being a victory. It was to retain or to gain the seat and get two Sinn Féin seats.
Even compared to 2011 or 2016, I might say, Catherine Riley had 6,000 votes. You come in with almost, probably according to the tallies, over 9,000.
Yeah, well, I suppose in 2016, West Cavan
was outside, in a different constituency. It was only a 4-seat constituency. So
yes.
It was always going to be different.
It was always going to be different. Yes.
But at the same time, the turnout has been quite incredible.
I suppose people in this constituency and all around the Cavan Town area and the side as well. And I suppose there's a way of support behind us at the moment. So.
And looking nationally, I mean, the next big question is when, you know, or what form the next government is going to take.
Yeah, well, I suppose until all the votes are counted and we know exactly the shape up of numbers, you know, within all the parties, it'll be horse trading time, as they say. I don't know. I mean, our preference would be a left-wing coalition. I don't know if the numbers are going to allow that this time. But we have said from the beginning we are open to talking to it. We were not presumptuous about, you know, who we would or whether or not, you know, everybody deserves to be represented. Other parties said they weren't going to talk to us, they weren't consider who we should be, which we think was somewhat arduous. However, I suppose it would be down to Mary Lou to lead discussions with other party leaders if they're willing to sit down and discuss.
I mean, there's no way you'd get a majority in government unless it's a left alliance.
Yes.
But, I mean, you mentioned earlier on when we were chatting, I mean, it's great in hindsight looking back, you could have maybe ran more candidates in some areas.
Yes. Well, look, we didn't have a good local and European election last May, so based on that, it would have been foolish for us to actually run more candidates. We ran what we thought were conservative enough numbers, but we thought were achievable. So we had no way of knowing until the election was actually launched that, you know, things were going to turn out the way. So hindsight's a great thing, but unfortunately, we weren't aware when we started the election campaign that we were going to be so popular.
And popular right across the country, because you're talking polls left and centre.
We are, yeah, with surpluses enough to bring a second candidate in many ways.
Yeah.
I suppose one thing we have to look at is if a government cannot be formed this time and we have to go back to the poll, or, you know,
you have more imminent concerns for yourself, and I know you have Monday off.
Yes.
But then thereafter, you're an elected TD, you know, heading forward. You're going to have to go back into school and say goodbye to your students.
I will. Look, I think what normally happens is you look for leave of absence, and there are a number of TDs who are ready, who were teachers and who were elected and have done that, so basically there. So I will be looking for leave of absence for the length of this long term.
And will you go and say goodbye to your students?
Oh, absolutely. Yes.
Brilliant. Pauline, thank you so much.
No problem.
The headline, teacher lady.